called down. No, that's Britt Grimshaw. To the 46-yard line. It is a gain of five. It will be second down and five. Rod Webster on the tackle.
You can only throw it so many times. The Leathernecks have to try to establish a ground game. They were outstanding against Arkansas Tech. It's a different story tonight against the Bulldogs. But they have to get some yards on the ground to open up that pass game a little bit more.
Earl and Beebe go to the left.
Now they're sitting in the shotgun to give Singer more time because of the furious Bulldog rush.
Rivera is blitzing from the left side, but the pass is complete to Grimshaw, no gain. Third down and five. Excellent coverage by the defense led by Chris Reinhardt.
Singer's a very intelligent quarterback. He's got a grade point average of over 3.6. Could be an honor student. And when you blitz a guy like this who's got a good arm and good mobility, you're taking a real dangerous situation into your own hands if you're the defense, because Singer will find the proper target. You're right, though. That was good defense there, but Singer got the ball to the right guy.
He's 1 for 2 in third down conversions. You might remember the last one on third down at 16. He dumps it off. The pass is complete, and it is near a first down. Yes, he has it. The big tight end, Jeff Prentice, who caught a pair of touchdowns last week. He's not very big, as you see by his numbers, but he is a real fighter.
We talked about Singer. He's looking for his tight end here, number 85. A very aggressive football player. Watch him put the head down there. Harris made the tackle. But again, they're utilizing all the elements of the offense. They've been throwing it to the wideout. They've been throwing to the backs. Now they get the tight end involved. You want to spread out that Bulldog defense.
First down from the 39-yard line. Millsap cuts his way to the 36.
Trying to establish the ground game. Now they're going to try to run wide. I don't know that they can do that against the superior speed of this football team from Fresno State. And Jay Wilkerson with a good hit using the shoulders to drive the running back Claude Millsap to the ground.
You know, their coaching staff was saying that we cannot overpower Fresno State. We must do things to fool them, confuse them. And right now they're doing that on this drive, starting from their own 20-yard line. It's second down and seven. The blitz was on. The pass is knocked in the air and almost intercepted. Darrell James was laying on his back and slipped in the turf. May have been able to haul that in. Singer comes to the sideline. He will face another important third down situation, needing 7 yards this time.
Well, he's a good quarterback, and we've talked about him. He's thrown 22 touchdowns in his career. He's a real winner. He's won 9 of his 14 starts, and it's a very sophisticated offense, which will show a lot of formation, and they'll spread that offense and try to pick holes in your defense.
Again, they send that unusual formation, 3 receivers to the left side, 1 lone setback. Singer throws, completes the pass, near a first down. I believe he'll be about a yard shy. Let's see where they mark it. He just did get 1 foot across that 30-yard line and just barely needs to make it near the 29.
Good pass protection for Singer. And Borich got open on a slant pattern. They feel that's open in the Bulldog secondary. And then James made the stop. But they will take what the defense will give you, try to set up the long bomb. You can see it coming. They'll try to suck that defense in a little bit later. You can expect to see Singer try to go for the home run.
And I'm sure the defensive coaches for Fresno State, as we look at a fourth down and about a yard situation for Western Illinois, I would imagine the defensive coaches are up here in the box talking on the phone to their defensive coaches on the field saying, hey, this is what we're doing wrong. This is what we have to correct. But they're trying to correct it while the defensive team is on the field.
Well, it's tough to stop a sophisticated offense when they execute well. And right now, the Leathernecks have everything in gear. They're a well-oiled offensive machine. And it's crucial, too. They've kept the ball and kept their defense off the field.
Grimshaw, I think he was able to slide forward just barely. The hit was supplied by Dave Ferguson and Jethro Franklin.
Brett Grimshaw is a hard running back. In fact, he impressed Coach Jim Sweeney of the Bulldogs very much. He stopped at the line, but he has that strength. He keeps the legs moving to fall forward there on that extra lunge. We have a measurement coming, but from our angle, it looks like that extra oomph got him the first down. But it is close. It goes over on down.
Wow. Big play by the Fresno State defense. Our score is 7-0. The Bulldogs lead with 3:45.
Today's game is brought to you in part by True Value Hardware. More than just a name, it's our way of doing business. And by Allstate Insurance.
True Value Hardware stores present a sneak preview of great values in the Fall Preview Circular, where the Casio 8-digit solar-powered calculator is just $2.88, and a pack of three Value-Bright inside frost bulbs is only 99 cents. Prevent costly heat loss with Red Devil Lifetime Caulk, just $1.66, less a $1 mail-in rebate. And get a selection of Servez plastic trash bags, just $1.69 a pack. Now showing at participating True Value Hardware stores and home centers.
3 minutes, 45 seconds left in the first quarter. Fresno State with that 7-0 lead. It came on a Dave Telford to Brock Smith's 17-yard touchdown pass. But since that time, Western Illinois has taken nearly 6 minutes off the clock on a very impressive drive. But the Fresno State defense stood tough on a fourth down and 1 foot, and they had the football.
Touchdown pass by Dave Telford has to give him a real lift from a confidence standpoint. You know, he was the fifth string signal caller in spring, and here he is in front of a sold-out crowd in the home opener running the offense.
He wants to throw on first down, and he wants to go long. Has a man out there. Andre Alexander may have let up just a bit as the football was approaching because it looked perfectly thrown by Dave Telford.
Alexander lost concentration at the last moment. Andre runs the 40 and 4-4, and he was flat gone. And right there, and went right through his hands, that should have been a touchdown. Perfectly thrown by quarterback Telford. You could not put it on the hands any better than that. And that secondary was beaten badly.
Second down and 10. Kelly Skipper. Nailed at the 31-yard line. Gain of just 2, third down and 8. Smith, Jay Wade.
What do they call those legs? Sequoia stumps? What a build for Kelly Skipper.
Big third and 8 facing the Bulldogs and their quarterback, Dave Telford.
After that first series, he's really settled down.
Here's the reverse to Ron Jenkins. He wants to throw the football. Brock Smith is out there, and it is intercepted at the 18-yard line. Maurice Smith with 2:54 remaining in the first quarter. Fresno State clinging to a 7-0 lead.
Someone put a fender in my left front fender.
Leave it to the good hands, people.
I gotta dent the door of my 4x4.
Allstate makes an accident a little easier to take. We offer a repair guarantee, and in most cases, we'll give you a settlement on the spot.
I parked in a lot in a place that I trusted, but when I returned, my window was busted.
Leave it to the good hands, people.
You're in good hands with Allstate.
A member of the Sears Financial Network.
Fresno State has the 7-0 lead, but Ron Jenkins just threw his first career interception. This was a young man who was a quarterback in high school, and he really cuts it loose. But here comes Maurice Smith, Randy.
That's great balance to get the interception. Maurice Smith is a pro prospect. A lot of the scouts like him. He's got size at 6'3", and he can really jump. Great speed, great concentration from the free safety position. Outstanding range.
So Western Illinois has the football, first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Beebe and Earl to the bottom of your screen. Singer has an opening. 28-yard line. Second down and 2.
Well, Paul can do that. We talked about his mobility at the top of the show. Makes him doubly tough. That's a nice scramble effort, solo effort by quarterback Paul Singer. You know, he's from Fort Knox, Kentucky. We all know there's a lot of money there. He actually worked at Fort Knox and was hauling around all these big gold bars, something like 57,000 gold bars when he worked at Fort Knox.
And he left?
And he left. And he's supposed to be smart.
Well, let's see if he can figure this second and two out. Oh, what a hit by Jethro Franklin. Right there along with Dave Ferguson.
Dave Ferguson is a transfer from Iowa State, and he wasn't fooled by this belly series at all. The second back, and he really stood up. Claude Millsap, that's a picture hit. NFL scouts like that kind of hit. And he comes up dancing. He was enthusiastic, and football is a game of enthusiasm.
He loses a yard. It's third down and three. Singer with the quick toss. It's a first down. Don Beebe to the 36-yard line. O'Leary. Rod Webster there to push him down. But again, that it seems what they're doing, Sandy, Randy, is setting the three receivers over there, and two of them are picking defensive backs, and the one guy is left open.
Well, you widen the field by utilizing everybody. Spread everybody out, and Beebe was set to the right side. They knew how many yards they needed for the first down, so they got it to Beebe, who's very fast in the open field. Neil had to pick up 4 yards, and he got it.
Outside Grimshaw, 40-yard line. He's to the 44. A gain of 7. Darrell James is there. Western Illinois is yet to hit the scoreboard. They are down 7-0 with 49 seconds to play in the first quarter, but they continue to run that clock. Second down and 2. Grimshaw, the lone setback. The quick toss to Beebe, makes the catch, has the first down, breaks a tackle. He's to the 40. He's inside to the 35-yard line. Harrison Webster there for the tackle.
Had a great block from Claude Millsap, number 24, the tailback, who came out of the backfield, had a look of a receiver, but he came downfield and cut down a Fresno State linebacker, which cleared the area for Beebe.
This time, Mike Borish goes to the left. Beebe goes to the right. And off back to the left side is Grimshaw. And Singer will pitch it out to Mike Cox. To the left side to the 30. To the 25. Out of bounds near the 20-yard line. Michael Cox, who last week averaged 7 yards a carry, has a first down.
16-yard run is just great blocking from the left side of the offensive line. Tackle there by James Rivera, and Cox able to turn the corner with his blazing speed. And I'll tell you, Western Illinois has a good looking offense.
And that is the end of the first quarter. Fresno State leading the Leathernecks 7-0.
Music sweeps are always at least 13 songs in a row.
On Fresno's Killer Bee, B95.
You've probably heard that Coors isn't pasteurized. Well, it's true. It's also true that Coors is the only major brewer who won't pasteurize any of their beer. The reason? It's taste. See, when you pasteurize something, you heat it. And heating hurts the taste of beer. So Coors purifies without heat. That helps make Coors a little less heavy, never bitter, with all the spirit of a great beer. So when you want a beer, it's just plain better. Coors is the one.
Lane Bennett is warming up on the sideline just in case that right leg is needed. It's a 7-0 football game, and we begin the second quarter.
They don't want Lane Bennett on the field. Western Illinois has had two long drives to come out with only 3 points on the road. That won't do it for them. They'd like to get the six here.
Total yards in favor of Western Illinois. And there's the completion at the 20-yard line. James Rivera on the tackle. Tom Bragg on the catch.
Tom Bragg, a quality tight end. They have two gifted performers at that position. We saw Jeff Prentice, 85, before, but Bragg has more athletic ability. He's a bigger target at 6'4", 225 pounds, and he can really motor.
Played on the Western Illinois basketball team last year as well. Caught 17 passes last season.
Well, he's got that big size, and he's got 4'6", 40 speed, so he's a deep threat from the tight end position.
Second down and 9. Singer with the man open, and he's knocked down to the 15-yard line. Forrest making the catch, Wilburn the tackle. It will be third down.
Borich will run those precise patterns. He's not going to beat you deep. I just got to believe at some point Singer's going to look for that up and out and then have the guy cut deep and go long. It's just a process so far for Western Illinois where they're taking everything underneath, and they've never gone for anything deep, at least not to this point.
We may see a blitz by Fresno State here on third down and about 6 yards to go. And it will come from the right side from Jay Wilkerson. Singer rolls away from it, though. Looks to the end zone. Fires the pass. And it is knocked down in the end zone. So it's fourth down, and that means Lane Bennett. Webster was there. Wilburn was there. John O'Leary was there.
Dave Ferguson on defense, 91, really disrupted this play. Watch him running laterally with Singer, and he destroyed it because Singer couldn't turn the corner and forced him to throw the ball into a crowd, and Singer's fortunate to get it back.
He really is, because Webster and James and everybody was right there. Bennett from the 22-yard line, 32 yards out. It is no good. Wide to the left side. That is his first miss of the year. He was perfect last week, 2 for 2. And with 13:24 left in the first half, Bulldogs 7, Fresno State leading.
At first glance, you may not recognize the number one car in customer satisfaction. It's not BMW or Mercedes-Benz. It's Acura, from a new division of American Honda, engineered to deliver all the performance of German road cars for thousands less. Acura, number one in customer satisfaction after just 1 year on the road. Want a closer look? Come to Fresno Acura and see for yourself why Acura leaves the competition in the dust.
Skipper on a little delay to open Fresno State's drive. They still have that 7-0 lead after a 32-yard field goal was missed by Lane Bennett.
This is just getting off the ball. The entire front wiped out the Leatherneck defense. Great blocking, and Skipper threw the hole, put the head down, and ran into Maurice Smith and picked up an extra few yards. But the offensive line in unison, and that's what it takes up there. You have to have teamwork. They really did a job.
Kelly Skipper having a fine night, 47 yards on 5 carries. This time, Dean Collins finds a hole, not much running room there. Gain of 2, it'll be second down and 8. Well, he had a tough game last week against Washington State. 84 yards, and they were tough inside yards. He's a leading rusher in California high school 1 year, gaining 2,100 yards.
Saying a lot there. Great players in Southern California. Collins did a real number in high school.
Skipper again near the 40-yard line. It will be third down and 5. A gain of 3. Skipper already has 50 yards in the game. His career best is 109.
Well, if he stays healthy, Steve, he figures to break the 100 mark numerous times, and the 109 level will be surpassed numerous times in his career.
That statistic very telling. Incomplete. They would have had the first down, but a vicious hit was put on by Al Davis. Mr. Collins.
Al Davis. I wonder if he has problems with luxury boxes now. Would not this Al Davis. This is a different guy. But look at him hit Collins. Ooh, that's a rugged hit.
He hits like an Irwindale Raider.
Huh. Well, you know that Al Davis would love to draft a guy by the name of Al Davis.
Here's Belli. He averaged 42 last week. And he hits it. And there will be a return by Maurice Smith. And Maurice Smith gets away from the first man and makes his way to the 39-yard line. With 11:39 left in this first half, 7-0 our score.
After the gold rush, when the riches seemed long gone,
there's no more gold in this river.
Some people who helped start PG&E,
we're not after gold,
used the miners' old water systems to run one of the first hydroelectric power plants in America.
Today, PG&E is a world leader in taking new technology and making it one of the comforts of home.
Western Illinois has moved the football, but they have yet to crack the scoring column. Grimshaw on the carry, gains a couple. It'll be second down. We'll call it seven. We'll call it six, actually, as they mark that football between the 43, 44 yard line. They need to get to the 49.
It's nice to move the football, but you'd like to produce some points. And I think Paul Singer and company really needs a scoring drive.
A first down is made, and Vic Jacobs is down on the field. Vic.
Okay, I'm right here with Al Davis, who made that tremendous hit a few moments ago. He is getting treated by the trainer. I think his helmet got jammed against his eye, but he's going to be all right, and he's going to be playing. But he is being treated by the trainer right now for an eye injury. Back to you guys in the booth.
And that was the hit where he really nailed Dean Collins as he was trying to make the catch near midfield on the Fresno State last possession. Singer has the first down, and he has an excellent first half.
Great numbers,
but no scoring. To the 47-yard line. There's the eye injury that Vic Jacobs was talking about to Al Davis. Helmet jammed right to the forehead. And this is Claude Millsap.
And he's going to run it to Jethro Franklin, who ran by the play, but he had the speed to come back and get the running back. That's why Jethro Franklin is being hailed as an All-American.
Second down and seven. From the shotgun, the pass is there, and it's caught beautifully at the 40-yard line. Again, it's the little guy, Chris Earl. He and Beebe have just been tremendous tonight.
I am really impressed with Paul Singer. It's hard to believe he was a walk-on 3 years ago, but he throws a strikingly nice aerial right into Earl's hands. He has the ball softly out there. He always seems to throw a catchable ball. You know, some receivers will complain because their quarterback will throw it right through them or not throw it hard enough. It just seems that Singer's pass is just nice and soft and into the hands of any receiver, and he seems to find a lot of them.
Well, he's 11 of 13 right now, and Grimshaw straight ahead for the first down. He needed to get just about a foot. They marked the football at the 38-yard line. Claude Millsap and Brett Grimshaw are the backs, Singer the quarterback, and the two receivers that have knocked around Fresno State so well thus far are Don Beebe and Chris Earl. Beebe will come to the bottom of your screen. And Steve Williams is in the game for Chris Earl. A blitz from the right side. The pass is complete at the 32-yard line. Beebe again with great coverage supplied by Darrell James.
Now, Darrell James read the play. Singer is going to his primary target, but he had enough zip on the ball to get it there in time. You see the gamble by James trying to get that interception, but the pass had enough extra pizzazz on it. Singer rifled the ball to Don Beebe. Again, it's just an excellent quarterback spreading the field, utilizing a number of different receivers and moving this football team.
We've only played 22 minutes, and Beebe already has six catches. Michael Cox for the first down to the 24, to the 21-yard line. Rivera having to make the stop.
Unbelievable time of possession of this game. It's all on the side of the Leathernecks. They've controlled the ball. It has to be alarming to them that they're still behind, though, 7-0.
That total you saw on the screen, 574 yards, was a freshman record for Western Illinois last year.
It's a tribute to Claude Millsap that he was able to beat Mike Cox out in the spring. They have two very good tailbacks in Millsap and Cox.
First down. Singer with the pass for the completion to the 15-yard line. A flag is down, and that is a rare mistake, perhaps, that Western Illinois has made in this game. Ball is at the 15-yard line. Now they are saying that it simply was a towel that fell from one of the players, and they have picked it up, and they have started the clock. It reads 7:27. Fresno State leading 7-0. Singer is moving this club, but he has yet to crack the scoring column. Completes the pass to Michael Cox. He's to the 11-yard line near a first down. I think he has it. Nick Ruggieroli there for the tackle.
They really have the Fresno State defense guessing. This time he sends Cox to his right, floods the zone. And all those receivers went deep, and nobody was left behind. And little Cox made the catch and went downfield. Ruggieroli, by the way, is an outstanding freshman along the defensive front for Fresno State. But look at those numbers. 13 of 15. Singer's putting on a clinic.
Now the field becomes a little shorter, though. And the hell, oh my, at the 11-yard line. John O'Leary, Jay Wilkerson, and company, Ron Cox.
You have to block to establish the run game, and the defense got right by the offensive line there. Great penetration from O'Leary first, and everyone else cleaned up.
So it's second down, 11.
Steve, we've seen a brilliant performance by Singer, though. He has really showcased this offense. It's a form of the run and shoot, and I'll tell you, he's really moved the football team.
He has a man wide open at the 5-yard line and could not hit him. Mike Borich was wide open. If he throws the football on target, it's 6 points.
Well, Borich is the only receiver back to his left. Everybody's going back to the right side, and Borich has one-on-one coverage. He got wide open, and the first bad pass of the game by Singer. And besides, Borich stumbled, and they're both upset.
Third down, 11. Take one. And there's a timeout on the field. Look at that. Wow. Conversions all going Western Illinois' way. But Fresno State still has the lead, 7-0.
Introducing the Bagel Breakfast Sandwich.
Come on over, baby. Won't be here for long.
Only at Burger King.
We ain't faking. Whole lot of breakfast going on.
Fast, tasty breakfast.
Fresh eggs.
Bacon, ham, or sausage with melted cheese on a hot stuffed bagel.
Come on over, baby. Whole lot of breakfast going on.
Burger King, the best food for fast times.
Every 2 months for the last 7 years, Leland Hess has driven 67 miles to get his car's checked and serviced. 67 miles. To Al, who owns a Shell Auto Care station. Al takes good care of Leland. You, however, are luckier than Leland, because there's probably a Shell Auto Care dealer like Al right in your neighborhood. You don't believe Leland drives 67 miles? Call him.
Western Illinois has been able to convert 5 of 7 third down plays, but they are down 7-0, and here is the biggest third down for them in the game. Third and 11 at the Fresno State 11-yard line. Jethro Franklin is there. The pass is thrown, and it is caught for a touchdown. Chris Earle.
James Rivera was coming out of blitz. 43 had Singer eye to eye. But Paul has that ability, that elusiveness to scramble. And he created the play, and that's a terrific throw. And his receiver, Earle, knowing his quarterback was in trouble, came back to help him out. Fabulous teamwork. I'll tell you, Western Illinois deserved that touchdown.
And with 6:05 left in the first half, a chance to tie this game up by Lane Bennett. It is good, and we are tied at 7 with 6:05 to play in the first half.
Where do you put your money while you're figuring out where to put your money? Park it at Coast Savings.
One rockin' evening at the Silver Bullet.
Want to dance?
No, they got good life.
You can't hear me, can you? I think you're beautiful. In fact, I think you look so hot. In here, isn't it? Of course, it's not so much the heat as it is the humidity.
No slowdown, Silver Bullet tonight.
During the Volkswagen Summer Clearance, you can get a great deal. Factory-to-dealer incentives make savings possible up to $500 off MSRP on GTIs and Golf GTs, or up to $1,000 off MSRP on Sciroccos and Quantums. And there's a special consumer offer of $3,500 off MSRP on Vanagon Camper. But hurry. When summer ends, so do the deals.
See your local Volkswagen dealer in Fresno, Merced, or Visalia today.
Paul Singer was the main man on this drive. 9 plays, 61 yards. And on third down, needing 11 yards, he got him. Chris Earle. And Earle has his first touchdown of 1987. This is James Williams. Finds an opening. And is hit, knocked down at the 35-yard line. Anthony Williams, rather. That's a first down for Fresno State.
That crease developed because of a great block on the specialty team by Jay Wilkerson. We talked about Wilkerson as a fine linebacker, as you see the quarterback change and Eric Bouchel's in. That was a crushing block by Wilkerson.
Bouchel started last week against Washington State. Fresno State wants to throw. Has the time. And what a catch at the 45-yard line. Ron Jenkins. 19 yards and a first down.
Great concentration. And seeing the ball into his hands all the way was Jenkins, looking back, beating double team coverage. But look at that. That's a beautiful sight and a magnificent grab by Jenkins.
It's the only area he could put the football, and he found it because that Mike Himley's right hand came swiping by, and Jenkins was just able to haul it in. He had a nice game last week. 5 minutes, 45 seconds left in the first half. Bulldog 7, Leatherneck 7.
Hey, see the fall start here. See the fall start, you got a new quarterback in, a little bit different cadence, way he calls the rhythm up at the line, and to throw off that line, but Bouchel and that team will adjust, probably on the next play.
The pass is complete. A first down to Craig Jones, but flags go down in the offensive backfield. It could be holding.
Bouchel knows he's got an exciting young talent in this tight end, Jones. And he had Jones wide open over the middle. Now the big tight end put his head down, but this one's going to come back, wiping out a very good gain for Fresno State.
So now it'll go from first and 15 to darn near first and 25 or 30.
I would expect them to come back to Jones.
Holding on the offense. First down.
Now, it may not be on this particular play, but that was wide open. The middle of the field was free for Greg Jones. So I would imagine maybe the next series or in the third or fourth quarter, look for the Bulldogs to go right back to that play.
They need 25 on this first down from their own 40. get to the opposition 35-yard line. A little hold, about 3-yard gain. Second down, 22. That was Courtney Griffin, who scored the only offensive touchdown for Fresno State last week.
I love the Jim Sweeney quote explaining the way Courtney Griffin runs. Like a startled deer in the woods. How descriptive, but he's a good freshman.
Bouchel has the time, completes the pass. This is Dean Collins to midfield, but they will need 15, maybe 14 additional yards for the first down, and it will be third down. Pat Sullivan, Thad Trump, there for the Western Illinois stop.
Bouchel knows he has long yardage, so you don't have to pick it up in one chunk. This is a second down play, so he gets part of it here with a fine strike to Dean Collins. They'll bring up a big third down play. You know, the Leathernecks, with the time of possession and the way they've controlled the ball, have been able to take Barry Belli, truly a weapon for Fresno State, out of this first half.
It's third down. Bouchel complete for a first down at the 32-yard line. And it was Craig Jones again. Randy, you said it. They went back to the big guy from San Jose, 6'4", 235 pounds. He caught 74 passes and 15 touchdowns in 2 years and was a first-team junior college All-American.
He originally attended California, so you know he's a big league player.
Back to pro set. Courtney Griffin is read beautifully and nothing's there. Fine read by Thad Trump, a 6'1", 220-pound freshman from Cahokia, Missouri. Second down and 12. Bouchel is 2 for 2 and 24 yards. Defense will say it was Ray Langham who moved. Brock Smith leaves the game. Andre Alexander is on. It was Ray Langham.
Two or three Bulldogs that pulled up prematurely.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. Second down.
3 minutes, 11 seconds remain in this half. Three penalties now for Fresno State. Two on this drive. Big hole right side. Dean Collins has an opening all the way to the 25-yard line. They will need three more for the first down.
The offensive line on the right side does an outstanding job here for Collins. Bulldogs 75, Langham, and 76, Withicombe, with great blocks for Dean Collins. And that's what it's all about, winning in the trenches. And right there, the Dogs got off the ball. And we have a penalty, and they're going to tack it on. And Fresno State will get a first down.
Dead ball, personal foul on the defense. First down.
It's an awfully big play. And Fresno State is huddling near their coach, Bruce Craddock, on the sideline. So timeout of the field. With 2 minutes and 52 seconds remaining in the first half, Fresno State and West Illinois are tied at 7.
Today's game is brought to you in part by Vons, where you'll find USDA choice cuts of beef, Vons, the more store, and by Online Computers Plus, the Valley's oldest computer specialty store.
Hi, can you show me an Epson printer for my business? During Epson's Breakthrough 87, I can show you printers with higher power, printers that lead the market in value, printers with 9-pin speed and simplicity, printers with 24-pin quality and versatility, printers with advanced Epson technology, printers with traditional Epson reliability.
I'll take the Epson.
They're all Epson.
I'll take them all.
Your business must be terrific.
How's yours?
Terrific.
Online Computers Plus in Fresno. Call 432-4324. Also in Modesto, Stockton, and Visalia.
Why settle for USDA inspected beef when you can have USDA choice beef at Vons? Consistently better in quality. And now Vons has lowered the price of USDA choice beef. Like our tender USDA choice boneless rib steak, only $2.39 a pound. Or USDA choice boneless chuck roast, just $1.29 a pound. Choice beef, now at outrageous prices. It's knowing more that gets you more. More savings and quality at Vons, the more store.
What makes the Valley great? The Raisins, the Dancing Raisins are here along with the Raisin Queen this year. And why are you guys here at Bulldog Stadium tonight?
Halftime show. You've got to see it. If you're not here, come. Go to Pasadena and see it.
Don't change the sets. Come right back and see the Raisins at halftime. Back to you guys in the booth.
All right. Kelly Skipper on the call. The carry. Only a couple as he nears the 10-yard line. Maurice Smith on the tackle. This is the first meeting between Western Illinois and Fresno State. Bruce Craddock in his fifth year. Jim Sweeney of Fresno State in his 10th year. Gain of one. It's second down and 9.
Now they've had success with the tight end. And keep in mind they ran that play at Washington State going back over the middle to the tight end.
Dean Collins is out to the left. They throw the football to Kelly Skipper. He breaks a tackle. He's in for the touchdown.
Kelly Skipper has improved as a receiver out of the backfield. And they utilize his speed, clearing the area. Hunter had a chance there. But Skipper able to dance into the end zone and get the Dogs the lead.
Boy, when you have that low balance, that real center of gravity that is low, as Kelly Skipper does, I thought Hunter had him, and he was able to just whip his way around. And now watch from the sideline as Barry Belli pushes Fresno State back to a 7-point lead at 14-7.
If the Chevy S10 Compact is so much fun to get dirty, how can you be sure that it's one of the best-looking compact trucks around? Because every now and then, someone washes one off.
The big one's back, and Chevy's got it. 1.9% financing on this big choice of new Chevy cars and trucks, or up to $1,000 cash back. The big one could be the best reason to see your Chevy dealer now.
Hi, I'm Mike.
She's busy.
Wouldn't life be wonderful if you got three chances at everything?
I'm just trying to win a little money here.
Yeah, we'll keep trying.
Okay.
Introducing Triple Chance, the new lottery game that gives you three chances to win on every ticket.
$25,000. I'm Debbie.
I'm Arthur.
I'm rich.
Triple Chance. If you got the itch to be rich, scratch a little every day.
Fresno State now leading 14-7, and this is that weird set as we take a look at the Fresno State scoring drive, 64 yards and 8 plays, and Eric Bushell really giving the team a lift as he came on in relief of Dave Telford. But down in the field, they're showing that same set that they showed Washington State last week when they had the onside kick and recovered, but it was a yard short of 10 yards.
All they want to do is disguise their game plan.
Belli. Deep to Wilcox. Seam off the right side. Flags go flying at the 28-yard line. We have 1:59 to work with here in the first half. Fresno State leading 14-7. I'm Steve Fizioc along with Randy Rosenblum and Vic Jacobs down on the sideline.
Clipping on the return. First down.
Right there. I believe the clip was against number 20, which is Cox. Although it could have been against Millsap, 24. They were both turning men around. And this is unfortunate for the Leathernecks, because field position and time is against them. A minute 59 as Jim Sweeney has a 7-point lead. But the way Singer's been running the show, it's going to be difficult for him to negotiate. Not impossible, but he has to bring his team 90 yards in less than 2 minutes.
Wilburn picks up Steve Williams, but the carry goes to Brett Grimshaw. And he is nailed for a 2-yard gain, and a timeout is called quickly by Fresno State.
They're confident defensively they can get the ball back and put some more points on the board. And again, you notice how conservative Singer and the offense came out. It was because of field position. It's a game of field position.
Singer comes to the sideline. He wants to talk with his coach, Bruce Kranick, who has had a great deal of success here at Western Illinois. In his second season, he went 6-4-1 and upended four Missouri Valley foes, Drake University, Southern Illinois, Illinois State, and the nation's number one ranked team, Indiana State, at that time. And he's done a fine job, and he says this quarterback here may be the finest quarterback he has had since he's been at Western Illinois.
Well, those numbers would bear that out. You're probably saying to yourself, as Jim Sweeney paces the sideline, how can Western Illinois play with Fresno State? But when you execute and don't make mistakes and have a guy like Singer rifling the ball all over the yard, you're going to stay in the game because of execution. That's what Vince Lombardi did with those great Green Bay Packers. Not necessarily all the greatest talent in the world. And there's a discrepancy here. Fresno State probably has more talent, but the execution, especially from the offensive side of the Leathernecks, has almost been 100%.
And they took 12 minutes off the clock on two drives alone. One failed with a missed field goal. The other ended with a touchdown pass from Singer to his wide receiver, Chris Earl. Singer wants to throw. Loops it deep. Wilburn with great coverage, and it's an incomplete pass at the 38-yard line. Wilburn just blanketed the little guy, Steve Williams. And it will be third down and 10. And that means Fresno State doesn't have to use it, but timeout. They have two left. The Leathernecks have but one. And if Fresno State can hold them here, they can get the football back with still a minute and a half remaining.
Jethro Franklin with good pressure from the right side forced Singer to throw that ball a little bit early, and it caused his receiver to break off his pattern short and really disrupted the play.
They'll go to the pro set in the backfield. On the draw. It's a first down for Western Illinois with a minute 38 remaining, and time is called again by Fresno State. And I would imagine Jim Sweeney unhappy with his troops there because they had an opportunity on third down and 8 to halt this Western Illinois drive and to get the football back in excellent field position.
Talk about execution, and Jim Sweeney knows he's seen a pretty good show from Western Illinois. Everybody in the stadium was thinking pass. Western Illinois and Bruce Kranick knew that, so they came back with the draw, and it worked perfectly.
This time, it is read beautifully. Tony Harris leading the way.
Well, Tony Harris may have made the tackle, but 54 freshman Cox, Ron Cox, really forced the play there and strung it out. And then everybody, including Webster, was able to get involved. But Cox, look at him come back into the pile. That's what a freshman will do. He'll play with enthusiasm. He doesn't know any better.
He only knows that there's a minute 14 left and that his coach would like that football back. Both teams with one timeout left. Tom Bragg checks out. Back in, big tight end Jeff Prentice. And that offensive line has done an excellent job. Mike Morrison, Keith Blue, Ron Nesbitt, Russ Ball, and Tim Harper on the front line.
Once again, a tremendous crowd at Bulldog Stadium. Looking at the berms behind the end zones. Here, there it is. Another Bulldog sellout, 30,000 plus, and great support at Fresno. Now the Dogs have built quite a tradition, and their fans have helped them out. But I think they have to rally them a little bit here because Western Illinois brought their game level up. They're playing against better competition. It's like a tennis match. Sometimes if you play an opponent, it's not that good. Your tennis game comes down. You play a great opponent, it goes up. And I think that's what happened to Western Illinois tonight. They're playing above their talent level.
Singer, here comes the pressure. It's incomplete at the 25-yard line.
kind of surprised at that call. Let me tell you why. Fresno State only had one timeout remaining. Again, Cox is going to put pressure on Singer, 54, exploding in. Now with this incompletion, Fresno State with the timeout and a third down coming, if they can hold here, will definitely get the ball back with right around a minute left and have time to position Barry Belli for potential 3 points.
He nailed three last week. Two were long distance, over 45 yards. Singer. They try to control Franklin again. The pass is there. It is almost intercepted. Rod Webster had a chance. Fred Wilburn had a chance. But it's incomplete in fourth down. 1 minute, 2 seconds to play in the first half.
And now with the incompletion, they can save the timeout, utilize it on offense. Little half sprint rollout and just a bad pass and nearly intercepted. Intended for the tight end, Jeff Prentice.
Andre Alexander standing back at his 42-yard line. Mike Krause set for the punt. The rush was on, the kick away, and it is not a good one. But it will take an excellent bounce, but let's see if it went out of bounds. It did at the 43-yard line. So the Bulldogs get the football back with 54 seconds remaining and a one important timeout.
Bulldogs look like they made the necessary adjustments defensively, tightening the screws on the Western Illinois offense. And Bouchel, who gave the team a lift, is back out there. He's got to be in a good mood. His brother Steve Bouchel at his 12th home run of the year last night for Texas in a win over the Angels.
And look how soft the defensive backs are playing. Way deep, like 15 yards up. Bouchel with time. Fires the football. Complete for a first down at the 38-yard line. Right now, they are in Belli territory. He nailed one from 53 last week. And he just barely missed from 62.
Too much of a cushion there in that secondary. Leatherneck cannot let the likes of a Brock Smith or a Ron Jenkins. Can't give him that many yards.
Jenkins to the right. And the pass is thrown to him. He makes the catch and is out of bounds to the 28-yard line. 43 seconds left in this first half. And a flag is down near midfield. Holding against the offense. I was just about ready to say a perfectly executed drive, and then the yellow flag falls. Still plenty of time and the one important timeout. Boy, that cushion that they're giving them. Their cornerbacks are staying back like 15 yards.
Too much, and it's hurting.
Holding on the offense. First down.
Right now, the Bulldogs are their own worst enemy.
Ball back at the 49-yard line. That offensive line is giving Bouchel some time. Brian Follin, Gary Walden, Paul Portese, Mike Withicombe, who's always outstanding, and Jeff Trushell. From the 49-yard line, it is first down. Bulldogs need 20. The blitz is on. The protection is there. Ron Jenkins is open, and the pass is knocked away at the 8-yard line.
That veteran offensive line of the Bulldogs does a great job of picking up the linebacker Trump there. Bouchel lays this out nicely, and good secondary coverage from Wilcox, knocking it away at the last possible instant.
Second down and 20. They must get to the 29-yard line for a first down. One lone setback. The pass is complete to Jenkins. Breaks the tackle. Out of bounds. First down. 28 seconds left. Man, I'll tell you what. They may have lost some great receivers and the touchdown maker, Stephen Baker, and Gene Taylor last year, but Ron Jenkins and Brock Smith, when they are told to run patterns a certain way, they run them exactly the way they're told.
They catch the ball and they know what to do with it. By the way, both Stevie Baker with the Giants and Gene Taylor with Tampa Bay are on NFL rosters. They've made the teams in the National Football League.
Blitz is on again. Bouchel unloads. It's broken up in the end zone, but flags go flying. Near the line of scrimmage. We'll wait and see here as Anthony Williams was the intended receiver.
Well, Bouchel wants all of it here. Cup forms nicely, a little bit of pressure, delivery sack there, and secondary doing a very nice job. Wilcox had the receiver blanketed. He's upset. He thought he should have the INT.
We'll wait for the referee here. It's against the offense. Well, they get themselves
pass
out of Belleye territory again.
Against the offense. Loss of down. Second down.
25 yards to go.
We have conquered the enemy, and the enemy is us right now for Fresno State.
Throw set in the backfield. Bouchel fell down, went to his knee, 48-yard line. It'll be third down and 20.
This is plain and simply stumbling when you're going back. Nobody touched him. And Bouchel goes to his knees, and in the college game, as soon as your knee touches, you are down.
Your statement before was so accurate. The enemy is us. That football team twice gets it inside the 28-yard line, and both times is penalized.
Well, it's third and 32, but I don't think that's the intention here. Obviously, you'd love to pick up 32. You'd like to make a touchdown. But if they could pick up 20, 15, 20 yards and give Barry Belleye a shot, I think that's going to be the game plan, unless they feel they can beat 11x deep, and they haven't been able to do so in the final moments. They've been playing back with that cushion. So I expect that they will run a 10 to a 15 yard pattern and try to pick up a good chunk and set up Belleye.
And they're going to have to go to the sideline because they have no timeouts left and just 11 seconds left in this game. So it'll be interesting to see how the defensive pressure tries to push the wide receivers back to the middle of the field. Two receivers to the left and Anthony Williams to the right. You see the situation. Third down, 33. And Bouchel off to the sideline again. Timeout is called by Western Illinois. Well, Jenkins and Smith are beginning to heat up as wide receivers for Fresno State. Jenkins with three catches. He had five last week. And Jenkins with 50 yards receiving. Smith, who had five catches last week, has two tonight with 31 yards. But the mistakes have been aplenty. And you can see Rich Olson, the offensive coordinator, talking to his young quarterback, Eric Bouchel, who just engineered a nifty drive for a touchdown to his running back, Kelly Skipper. And this time is denied by mistakes by his teammates.
They've been hit by the penalty bugaboo on this drive. And that has really hampered their offense. But I think in the last 6 or 7 minutes, they've taken control of the Bulldogs in the line of scrimmage. And I think as they go into halftime, whether they score here or not, not only are they ahead 14-7, but they'll go in with some momentum after the Leathernecks of Western Illinois had established dominance through a little bit better than a quarter and a half. But the last 6 or 7 minutes have been much better for Fresno State.
We've used them all up. Anthony Williams left. Brock Smith. And Ron Jenkins to the right. Bouchel from the shotgun. He is hit as he throws. The pass is out there. And what a catch at the 28-yard line. The clock will run out. And that is the end of the first half. A tremendous catch by Ronnie Jenkins.
Concentration again. It's a great throw, but Jenkins couldn't get out of bounds, so the clock expires. They got the proper chunk. Belleye was running out of the field of play, but we're at halftime. And you can see Jenkins thinking, I wish I was about 2 yards to...
was working their way magnificently down the field, led by Eric Bouchel, could not really control themselves, picked up three big penalties on that drive and came up with no points at all.
Paul Singer was outstanding in that first half for this team from Western Illinois, doing an outstanding job leading the offense, but only came up with 7 points. That's not going to get the job done as Fresno State leads 14-7 as the two teams get prepared for the second half. Paul Singer was outstanding.
He completed, what, 16 of 23 passes for 138 yards, was sacked twice, and they finally got a little pressure on him in the second half. But he was able to get that ball control offense, and as their coach was telling us before the ball game, Bruce Craddock, we're going to try and confuse the Fresno State defense. And I think they did that a little bit in the first half, and I think it's something that the Fresno State coaches have gotten into halftime, and with the strength of their football team, will be able to solve some of the gimmicks and confusion that Western Illinois caused in the first half.
Steve, I felt in the last 6 or 7 minutes of the first half, the Bulldogs took control of the line of scrimmage.
They really did. The only problem was they made the mistakes, and that cost them the penalties when Bushell had engineered 2 drives to his team's 28-yard line, only to have a holding call one time, two holding calls, as a matter of fact, to back that ball up to midfield.
Two teams on the field getting prepared for the second half. Statistically, very even football game. And after eating the coat, the mascot is huffing and puffing. 14-7, Fresno State leads. A lot of people felt this would be a blowout for the Bulldogs, but Western Illinois has come here and with ball control through the passing game has stayed close. Fresno State will be kicking off to start the second half, so Western Illinois will put that offense on the field first. And we talked about the numbers for Paul Singer, who was absolutely spectacular in the first half. Singer, 16 of 23 for 138 yards and a touchdown. Didn't throw an interception, but the Bulldogs were starting to put some heat on him at the tail end of the half. Now for the second half play-by-play, my good buddy. Go get him, Steve.
All right, Randy Rosenblum and Barry Belli kicks off and drills it into the corner of the end zone and through the end zone. A excellent kick by Belli completely takes away a return by Western Illinois. And they will jump out there with the same offense that started this game. And that means Paul Singer at quarterback with Brett Grimshaw and Cloyd Millsap in the backfield. The line, Mike Morrison, Keith Blue, Ron Nesbitt, Russ Ball, and Tim Harper with the receivers. Chris Earle, Don Beebe as the wide receivers, and Jeff Prentice is the tight end. Beebe will come to the bottom of your screen. Singer's numbers, well, he was just terrific in the first half, particularly in ball control. 12 minutes on 2 drives alone. Millsap for a short gain up to the 21-yard line, maybe the 22.
What Western Illinois really needs is a drive that will eat up some of the clock and a drive that will establish the running game. We talked about Singer's numbers, great through the air, but the running game was almost non-existent. And if they can establish that and hold on to the ball, Western Illinois, as this game goes on, is starting to believe in itself that they can play with the Bulldogs.
And they had that idea in the first half. Singer with time. Completes the catch, but again, it will be just for a short gain, maybe back to the line of scrimmage. John O'Leary read it beautifully and came from his inside linebacking position, the 6'4", 230-pound senior from Oakland, California. And he makes the tackle, and again, it will be a short gain. They will give him just about a yard, so we'll call it 3rd down and 7.
Boritz really pays the price there, going over the middle. John O'Leary really rode him down, horse-collared him down. There's a look at the senior linebacker. He's a tough customer. Had a bleeding ulcer earlier in the year, but he's healthy again, and that's good news for Bulldog fans.
Again, the 3 receivers to the left side, and they'll go with the same pattern they had in their first half, and they come up near a first down, but it will be stopped shy. Maybe a yard. Don Beebe. And that is his 6th catch of the night.
Good read, though, by the defense. Just a quick little pop pass, almost impossible to stop. And you can see how quickly the Dogs react to the ball. And it was Rod Webster that held them about a half a yard short.
Webster is all PCAA all the way. He knew exactly where that first down marker was. Rivera tries for the block. The punt is off, though, by Krause. And Alexander will take it at the 32. Try the sideline, but nothing's there. Down he goes, 37-yard line. And Fresno State goes on offense with 13 minutes to play in the third quarter, leading 14-7. Boo Bouchel comes on at quarterback. Kelly Skipper, Dean Collins in the backfield. Fallon, Walden, Portese, Withicum, Jeff Trushell on the line. The tight end is Rich Bartleski, and the receivers are Ron Jenkins and Brock Smith.
We're talking about Singer, but those are great numbers for Bouchel.
And good numbers for Kelly Skipper as well as he dances by the 40-yard line to the 42. Tackle is made by Marty Lomelino. It's a gain of 6 yards, second down and four.
Bulldogs up front, though, are winning the battle of the trenches right now, getting off the ball. Since about the six-minute mark left of the first half, they are really beating Western Illinois at the point of attack.
Dean Collins, near a first down. He'll be about a yard shy. They must get to the 47-yard line for the first down. Collins gets to the 46.
Marlon Williams, 99, is an aggressive defender here. You see him fend off two blocks and makes the tackle. One of the blocks was from Mike Withicum. And when you can do that, you're a pretty good football player. And Marlon Williams, they consider a great athlete. And his athletic ability stopped that play.
Double tight end on third and two. Skipper ahead. Nope, didn't get it. See where they mark that football. Again, he has to get that football just by the 47-yard line. Bouchel remains in the game. Jim Sweeney may want a measurement here. Again, Kelly Skipper's career high is 108 yards rushing. He has 59 already.
And it appears that the Bulldogs will go for it. Jim Sweeney has already shown us in the first game and a little bit more than a half that he has a willingness to be a crowd pleaser and go for it on unusual circumstances.
Full house backfield, Skipper ahead. I believe he's got it.
Very close, though. They good defensive charge.
Brought in the two tight ends. They had Swenning in the game with Craig Jones in that full house backfield.
Simple handoff to Kelly Skipper. And he fights forward. And that extra lunge, I believe, got him the first down. But again, number 99, Williams in on the tackle.
First down, Fresno State. 11:06, and there's the man, Kelly Skipper. Gain of a yard, he has 60 yards rushing now. From the 48-yard line. Bouchel, incomplete to Courtney Griffin. And the pressure was on from Marlon Williams, the 6'5", 250-pound junior from Tampa, Florida.
Well, they set the play up well, isolating one-on-one coverage out of the backfield, but the pass was thrown behind Courtney Griffin. The only one over in the area was the nickelback, Jay Wade. Now, nickelback, that's a confusing term. You think about a fifth defensive back. A nickelback in the scheme of Western Illinois is really like a linebacker. It's an extra backer in the game.
Well, they'll go to the straight set right now and second down and 10. Bouchel wants to throw. Has time, loops the pass out there. Complete for the first down. Brock Smith, he's out of bounds.
A precise down and out and good timing from the quarterback and the wide receiver. And a good throw by Bouchel. And you see number six, the defender, Wilcox, too much of a cushion again. And again, Brock Smith made him pay the price.
First and 10 from the 35. Smith has had a fine night. He caught the first touchdown of the game from Dave Telford. Courtney Griffin finds a hole, slashes his way to the 30. Wilcox there again. So is Marlon Williams.
Watch how high step, with the high step, the rhythm of a Courtney Griffin. And he almost uses his knees as a block for himself. He'll kick you in the face with that high step. Again, I like Marlon Williams coming over there from that left end. Very quick for Western Illinois.
Gain of 5, second and 5. Griffin again. Nothing there. Maybe one. Short four. Jim Sweeney, who was looking for his first victory of 1987. And Bruce Craddock, he won last week 48-9.
And the Bulldogs box opener at Washington State. They came out strong in the third quarter, drove the length of the field, and came away empty. They want to get some points on this drive and establish dominance.
Big third down. The pass is complete at the 21-yard line. And it's Ron Jenkins again. He has made three terrific catches, two in the first half, one here in the third quarter.
This time, though, Wilcox went for the interception, and it's a strong throw by Bouchel, and he came back to the ball. You see where Wilcox is. He's right there.
First down. 21-yard line. Jenkins will get a breather. Double tight end. Dean Collins dances up the middle, sneaks his way to the 18-yard line. Said his name a lot tonight.
I'm going to tell you this, the Bulldogs have really established the passing game now. They really have Western Illinois cognizant of the outside targets, so they're going to bash it up the middle a few times to try to get that running game going. But right now, Western Illinois is concerned because they've really lost sight of that outside game. Right now for Fresno State, they're completing everything to the wideouts.
Second down eight. Dean Collins, nothing there again as he's wrapped up as he makes his way to the 17-yard line. It will be third down, a long six. And you might remember last week, Randy, a very impressive drive by Fresno State to start the third quarter failed at the 2-yard line. So a big third down call here.
But you get the feeling that the Bulldogs can convert with that passing game. Say if you see a blitz here from Western Illinois. They have not done anything to try to disrupt the rhythm of Eric Bouchel.
He wants to throw. Has plenty of time. The pass is batted down and almost intercepted. Terrific play, Billy Hunter. And it's fourth down, and that means Belli time.
Well, they're able to get more pressure, but they got it from the defensive front. 99 Marlon Williams forced the hand of that man, Eric Bouchel.
You know, I'm really surprised we haven't even seen Eric Bouchel drive that ball down the field and get in position for Barry Belli. This is the first time we've seen number 27 attempt a field goal. He was 3 of 4 last week. And his numbers, he's looking for number 58. Is he something else? 17-7. Barry Belli. 7 minutes and 58 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Bulldogs by 10.
Where do you put your money while you're figuring out where to put your money? Park it at Coast Savings.
If you want the training you need to get a job you enjoy, here's all you need to know. That's the number for Healed Four Seas College. The college that placed over 96% of its last graduating class in jobs of their choice. Now that you know how to get the best training for a job, who are you going to call? The choice is yours.
At first glance, you may not recognize the number one car in customer satisfaction. It's not BMW or Mercedes-Benz. It's Acura, from a new division of American Honda, engineered to deliver all the performance of German road cars for thousands less. Acura, number one in customer satisfaction after just 1 year on the road. Want a closer look? Come to Fresno Acura and see for yourself why Acura leaves the competition in the dust.
Barry Belli, who just booted a 34-yard field goal to give Fresno State a 17-7 lead, now kicks off to Wilcox, who was almost tripped up at the 12-yard line, and now will be wrestled to the ground at the 15. Well, I tell you what, I think the Bulldogs went into the locker room, and their coaches had something to say to them, Randy.
I don't think there's any question about that. They're riled up. They're playing at home. It's their home opener. They don't want to lose in front of their fans. No question at all regarding that. On this kickoff, an outstanding play by Antoine Holly, 97. He forced the play. The number 97 came back for help. Well, that could have been a pretty good return.
Boy, that was a swarming special teams effort. First down, 10 yards to go, 15-yard line. Singer back to throw. Intercepted. Only man there is Darrell James. And the man with the hot hand in the first half, Paul Singer, has suddenly cooled off. Remember when he was 13 for 15. He has cooled off considerably, and he has completed just 30% of his passes since that time.
Well, Paul's feeling more heat now. Fresno State's getting great penetration from that front. The linebackers have been coming on occasion, but still the numbers are very good. There still has not been a major mistake by Western Illinois. An incompletion here or there is not going to hurt them. No turnover, so they're going to stay in the game unless they make the big mistake.
Second and 10. Jethro Franklin.
And there's the pressure from that defensive front. He had 19 and a half sacks a year ago. 67 is a man possessed and on a roll now to get to the QB, and he's nailing him right there. Ferguson came in a little bit late, but there's Franklin, who's doing the dance.
Remember last year when he had the 5 sacks in the opening game that he played at Fresno State? He said going into that game, so take a look at his numbers last year, he said, "I was freaking out. It was a major college game," and he used the word freaking out. Well, right now he is really freaking out. Paul Singer, pressure's there, the ball's in the air, it is caught, and down goes Grimshaw. Shy of a first down, it will be fourth down, and that could have been very, very disastrous near the 5-yard line.
Greg Attaid nearly had an interception. I like this call with the pressure coming. The screen was the proper call. But look at Attaid there tipping the ball up, and Grimshaw in the right place at the right time. That was great defense by the Bulldogs. The Leathernecks very fortunate to get a gain out of that.
Krause standing at his 5. Alexander will have a return. The wall is set up on the left side. A great block. And Andre finds a sideline to the 50. He's to the 40. A flag is down. Alexander will go the distance. Touchdown, Fresno State. But hold on here. There is a yellow flag at the 46-yard line after a 58-yard return by Andre Alexander.
What a block by Antoine Holley, though. The clip will take it back. No clip there. That was Bowen's block. There's Holley's block. That didn't look like a clip. Trump missed him there. Alexander will make you miss. Millsap can't get him there. Then a great cutback. I didn't see any clips. If we had one, it was out of our picture. But Alexander with a magnificent move. 4.440 speed, and he was a lightning bolt waiting to get into the end zone.
Well, Harris with the clip, so they bring it back. But that is just an indication of the excitement that Andre Alexander is going to bring Bulldog fans in the future. He was a young man who led the state junior colleges of California last year at 26 yards per punt return. He had 3 touchdowns. Bouchel wants to go deep. He has a man out there. It's incomplete at the 18-yard line. Brock Smith, with that fine speed, was able to get the edge on number 4, Bill Hunter.
The philosophy of Fresno State is to put it out there deep. Brock Smith had a step on Hunter, but it was just overthrown. The Bulldogs have been taking the 10 and the 15-yard patterns. They had it set up nicely. They just weren't able to execute it, but it was there for
him. Smith to the right. They're going for it again. This time it's Alexander, and a flag goes down about the 25-yard line. This may be against the offense.
Andre Alexander pushed off. I like the call, though. It was open, so let's go back to it immediately. You'll see Alexander, who had a step, he's going to push. Well, we're a little after that point, but he had pushed off to get behind Hunter. An easy play to call. See if we can catch it on this angle. Right there, he shoved off. Official Johnny on the spot, and Alexander couldn't quite bring it in. But this is a damaging penalty because it's loss of the yardage on the penalty and down.
Pass interference against the offense, loss of down, third down.
That's 8 penalties now for 77 yards, and they have all been costly.
Isn't football a roller coaster ride? Andre Alexander takes him back the distance as it called on the penalty. And now he's penalized for the long pattern.
He's going for it again. Incomplete at the 30-yard line. Brock Smith came back in the game. They went for 3 home runs. And the crowd is booing. interference.
It looked like Hunter was holding on. Number four. Might have been incidental bumping, though. And Brock Smith, I think that, too, was a proper call. And again, penalties hurt Fresno State.
Belli, there will be a return. Smith from the 28. Nothing there. Great special teams effort by Fresno State in this second half. Claude Brown.
That speed and speed on the football team includes the specialty unit. They got down there in great coverage, and Claude Brown made a nice hit. See if they try to roll Singer out now. He's felt a lot of pressure the last couple series. And I wouldn't be surprised if Bruce Craddock uses a sprint-out system here to try to move him away, especially from Franklin, and get away from that pressure.
Singer looking for an opening. Nothing's there. The pressure is on. Here comes Ruggeroli. It's incomplete. At the 35-yard line, second down and 10. We have 5 minutes, 33 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Fresno State 17, Western Illinois 7.
Leatherneck may have to go back to the screen or the draw, misdirection, because right now the Bulldogs are really putting the heat on that man, Paul Singer.
Says it was a fumble, but to the officials.
Officials have not made a call yet. They're looking at one another. Incomplete.
Yeah, I thought it was just in his hands and he struck the football.
Never had control of it, Borich. It's probably better off that he dropped it because the Bulldogs had diagnosed the play.
So it's third down. Singer needs 10. Beebe will come in the game, number 5, who has been his ace in the hole on third down plays.
They have to move Singer out of the pocket or go out of the shotgun because he's not getting enough time to throw the ball. They haven't gone from the shotgun since the first quarter.
The rush is on. Singer under pressure. Completes the pass for a first down. Rivera finally hauls him down at the 43, but Singer really held his poise there.
The ability to move within the pocket. You talk about quick feet for linemen. Well, quick feet for a quarterback is very important, too. Hey, he's saying, hey, where's my help? Where's my play? Well, watch how he moves around within the pocket. The quick feet steps up in the cup and finds the target. Again, that's outstanding quarterbacking by Paul Singer, and a good reception there from his wide receiver, Steve Williams.
42-yard line, first and 10. On the draw. This is Grimshaw. Big hole. Nears a first down. I believe he has it.
Well, you have to take the pressure off, and one of the ways to do it is the draw play. And Grimshaw's a hard running back, and he had a gaping hole. Harris came up from the safety spot to make the stop. But you'll see screens and draws and delays and misdirection when you got that kind of heat on you.
And when you average 5 yards a carry, you're helping your ball club. And right now, Grimshaw is doing just that. 4.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Bulldogs lead by 10. Singer with pressure from Rivera. In trouble. He's sacked. Fregatade. His second sack of the game. And he's the young man who was playing behind William Brown last week. And he's having a heck of a night.
He's been a spark on that defensive front. Rivera's blitzing. Nobody's open. So Singer's going to tuck it under and just run for his life. And he never saw a Tate. You notice Rivera on the blitz forced the play and forced Singer back into the cup. And then the Tate just came over and cleaned up.
Tade forces a loss of 12 at second down 22.
You know, he's originally a linebacker, so he's quick up in that front wall.
Outside backer last year. Action pass. Man was open. Singer just couldn't find him. Chris Earl was out there at the 50-yard line, but that would have been well short of a first down. So it'll be third and still a long 22 yards to go. The secondary's really working together. Much better than second half. Fred Wilburn, Tony Harris, Rod Webster, and Darrell James doing the job now.
It's easier to work together when you have a front wall that's applying so much pressure on the quarterback, and he doesn't have the time.
McCabe, Jethro Franklin, Dave Ferguson. Those are the gentlemen that Randy is speaking of. Here comes a Tate again. He had him by the collar and rips him down. Three sacks for Craig Tate. He had 3.5 all last year.
When it's third and 22, you're not going to buy the play action fake. Singer went to the play action fake. He used the half rollout, but Tate just overpowered everybody on that offensive line. And right now, the Bulldogs are dominating the line of scrimmage. And that's what football's all about. If you win in the trenches, you'll win the game.
Fresno State going for the block of the kick. Andre Alexander calls for the fair catch, makes it, drops the football, but down he goes to the 24-yard line. Fresno State leads 17-7 with 2:56 to play in the third.
You've probably heard that Coors isn't pasteurized. Well, it's true. It's also true that Coors is the only major brewer who won't pasteurize any of their beer. The reason? It's taste. See, when you pasteurize something, you heat it. And heating hurts the taste of beer. So Coors purifies without heat. That helps make Coors a little less heavy, never bitter, but with all the spirit of a great beer. So when you want a beer, it's just plain better. Coors is the one.
The score 17-7. Fresno State has the football, and on first down, they gain a couple. It'll be second down and 7, and the new quarterback is Dave Telford. Well, the two-headed quarterback continues. Telford, number 17, and 12, Eric Bushell. Telford started, gave way to Bushell. He carried the team for a while, gave them 10 points, and now Telford's back out there. He completes his first pass. DeRon Jenkins breaks the tackle. Stopped finally at the 42-yard line by linebacker Marty Lomolino.
Wilcox missed the tackle downfield, and that spun Ron Jenkins. Jenkins is also going to get a great block downfield from Dean Collins, number 33, who fended off Maurice Smith. Wilcox didn't square up, didn't make the proper tackle. Right there, Collins made that great block on Maurice Smith.
Lomolino in double figures and tackles once again. Fresno State with a quick switch. Tight end goes to the right side, Craig Jones. Slot left. And the handoff up the middle to Courtney Griffin. Short gain to the 40-yard line. Gain of 2, second down and 8.
Want to go behind a great wall. That's Mike Withicum, 76. Why not follow an all-PCAA performer? Pretty good penetration, though, from that defensive line led by Brian Cox of Western Illinois.
Excuse me, I called that Courtney Griffin. That was Kelly Skipper, and he has 65 yards. Jenkins, 5 catches last week. He has 5 more tonight. Telford has room to run, and he will. Oh, he throws the football instead. I think he was in beyond the line of scrimmage. I guess not. He threw the football just before, but he had a big opening there, and I thought he might take it. And I think Jim Sweeney may be talking to him just about that.
That's what it's known as indecision. You either do or you don't, and he didn't really neither. I think the wise decision, and of course hindsight is always 20-20, would have been to tuck it under, take the 5 or 6 yard gain and get out of bounds, but he was caught between a rock and a hard place and unloaded, and it was almost a turnover. He should have run the football.
Third down and 8. Smith, Jenkins to the left. From the I formation. Telford downfield, incomplete. Apparently he thought Smith was going to curl before he did, and the Jenkins was a little deeper. So it is fourth down and punting situation.
You know, it's almost field goal range. Belly's going to punt here. It would be a 57-yard try, but they're not going to go for it because they're playing field position right now.
Minute 9 to play in the third quarter. Belli is very good at this, angling his kicks, and he will hit it long, and it will go into the end zone. First and 10 for Western Illinois at the 20-yard line with a minute to play in the third period. Fresno State leading 17-7. We'll pause and let you hear these messages.
There's one thing you'll have to do to convert the stylish Chevy S10 Blazer from a good-looking vehicle into a tough off-road vehicle. Get out of town.
The big one's back, and Chevy's got it. 1.9% financing on this big choice of new Chevy cars and trucks, or up to $1,000 cash back. The big one could be the best reason to see your Chevy dealer now.
On first down for Western Illinois, this is Claude Millsap. An 8-yard gain, it'll be second down and 2. Tony Harris having to make the tackle.
Very coachable runner is Millsap, and he's like a coach on the field here. This is, I don't think the tackling is too precise, but it's a good cutback right there. Got a fine fend-off block from Williams, and a nice effort from Claude Millsap. Tony Harris out of the secondary. The free safety finally had to haul him down.
Singer needs only 2.
Red Wave is really in full swing right now.
First down, Grimshaw. Found the hole off the left side by Russ Ball. Well, our attendance tonight, and it is terrific. Another sellout plus 34,325.
And the Red Wave is doing their thing right now.
14 seconds to play, and the clock is winding down. And that may be the final play of the third quarter, and it will. So clock runs down 3-2-1. We have 15 minutes left of college football here at Bulldog Stadium. Our score, 17-7, Fresno State.
Hi, I'm Tom Long from Long's Building Supply. Come with me on a very special tour of the atrium door system. An atrium door in your bedroom lets the light in, but because the glass is insulated, it keeps the heat and cold out. They'll give you years of clear and attractive viewing. And they're available in many different sizes. We at Long's Building Supply are proud to be an authorized atrium door dealer. I just thought you should know that.
During the Volkswagen Summer Clearance, you can get a great deal. Factory to dealer incentives make savings possible up to $500 off MSRP on GTIs and Golf GTs, or up to $1,000 off MSRP on Sciroccos and Quantums. And there's a special consumer offer of $3,500 off MSRP on Vanagon Camper. But hurry, when summer ends, so do the deals.
See your local Volkswagen dealer in Fresno, Merced, or Visalia today.
Fresno State has not suffered consecutive defeats since the end of the 1984 season. Right now they lead by 10, and right now they're beginning to take control of this football game. Total yards was led by Western Illinois at halftime. Right now it's almost 100 yards in Fresno State's favor.
Well, the Bulldogs have gotten their passing game going. It's all been ignited by the defense, though, which has frozen Paul Singer for about a quarter now. Singer has been unable to move his team.
First down, nothing there. The play was read beautifully by Jay Wilkerson, the linebacker, coming from the opposite side. Number 35 was right there.
You know, Rodney Dangerfield says, I ain't got no respect. Well, right now, Fresno State, the Bulldogs, don't respect the offensive front of Western Illinois. They're teeing off. They're going after everybody. So, again, you got to go back to the screens, maybe a draw, and you got to roll out. The play action stuff won't help you because they don't believe in the play action. They're going after the quarterback.
But it all adds up to a second down 11. They split their backs wide. Singer wants to throw. Plenty of time. Incomplete. Intended for Bragg, his big tight end at the 45-yard line in Fresno State territory.
Well, Singer went for the big play here. five-step drop, and Bragg is an outstanding tight end, and that was not a good throw. Bragg was open. He had split the defense, and a good aerial would have meant a lot of yards for the Leathernecks. And now they're looking at third and long.
Well, after 16 for 23 in the first half, Singer is 4 for 9 this half and only 33 yards. He has yet to hit the scoreboard. His team down by 10, 17-7. Shotgun formation. Third down, they need 11. Incomplete. Flag goes down. They may say he was just trying to get rid of the football because Dave Ferguson had him wrapped up. That is 5 sacks. Tade has 3. Jethro Franklin has 1.
Sure, there's a hole or a clip in the middle of that line. Too much pressure for Singer. He did well to unload. Again, he's mobile, so he can sprint through there. Saw Ferguson get to him, and he threw it downfield. There was a receiver in the area, so he didn't ground the ball. Singer's a very intelligent QB, and he's just a man on the run as his team is outmanned right now.
Against the offense has been refused. Fourth down.
The crowd is really into the game, and it's been spearheaded by the defense. And they're a real factor, and I think Western Illinois, which came in believing through the first half, is a little bit intimidated now. Fresno State's got control of the line of scrimmage, and they got 34,000-plus screaming and hollering on their side.
Andre Alexander drops back at his 31. Almost blocked by Garnett Fountain. Alexander drops it, scoops it up, and down he goes at the 30-yard line. 14 minutes to play in the ball game. Bulldogs 17, the Leathernecks 7.
Hi, can you show me an Epson printer for my business? During Epson's Breakthrough 87, I can show you printers with higher power, printers that lead the market in value, printers with 9-pin speed and simplicity, printers with 24-pin quality and versatility, printers with advanced Epson technology, printers with traditional Epson reliability.
I'll take the Epson.
They're all Epson.
I'll take them all.
Your business must be terrific.
How's yours?
Terrific.
Online Computers Plus in Fresno. Call 432-4324. Also in Modesto, Stockton, and Visalia.
When Andre Alexander fumbled the football, a Western Illinois player was called for a late hit. They've been penalized 15 yards. The ball is at the 46-yard line, and Eric Bushell is back in at quarterback.
Now, Fresno State looking for a backbreaker. Now they have a 10-point lead, but a score here would really hurt the Leathernecks' chances.
Kelly Skipper, flag goes down. Skipper's to the 50. He's to the 43-yard line. Courtney Griffin knocked down that twice.
Mike Withicum came up a little lame, too. That could be dangerous. 76, a good football player. Courtney Griffin, big hole. Line of scrimmage totally dominated right now by the Bulldogs, and they're doing whatever they want with Western Illinois. But again, the penalty will bring this one back. And they have been their own worst enemy, but they're dominating the game right now.
Illegal formation against the offense. First down.
Well, they're having to get creative for penalties now.
9 penalties for Fresno State, 4 for Western Illinois. And there are the numbers, 87 yards to 48. And that's been a big difference in the game. Fresno State could have pulled away. Griffin spinning for several yards to the 48-yard line. It's back past the original line of scrimmage, a gain of about 7. It'll be second down, maybe 8.
The spirit of the Leathernecks might be behind him right now. Some arm tackling there against Courtney Griffin. And what appeared to be a 2 or 3 yard gain produced 7 yards. So I think that heart is being taken away from the Leathernecks as Fresno State is winning the battle.
Nickel defense and Griffin up the middle to the 15, and then he's hit knocked down. Third down, 6 yards to go.
That's a good football player, though, in Maurice Smith. He won't quit. 6'3", size, speed, guts, intelligence. He is the true leader of the defense for Western Illinois, along with Lomo Lino, the linebacker.
And now the red white face another important third down. But Nate Sticks, Bushell wants it. Goes to his tight end, Jones. He has the first down to the 43-yard line. And was that ever a good play by Jones? He set up in the middle. Bush- Rochelle was looking at him. He was covered. He curled back to the inside. And brother, he makes the catch.
I love this man's hands. Frank Jones, right there. Sure-handed. And again, we talked about Maurice Smith and Loma Lindell. They're the two guys there back on defense. But Jones has those great hands. When the ball's in the area, he's normally going to get it for you.
Griffin slides to the 40. Gain of two, second down and eight. Ryan Cox in the tackle. They like this Courtney Griffin. He goes 5'11", 175, and he was a redshirt freshman. Fresno Central here in town. Gained 1,251 yards his senior year in high school.
Fresno State doing what they have to do. They have a 10-point lead. They're dominating the game, and they're occupying the clock. Under 12 minutes left.
From the 40. Rochelle has the pass knocked down. Third down and eight.
Well, on second and long, the Leathernecks just teed off and came after Rochelle. See, from the left there, ball was knocked down. Couldn't quite get the number on the Leathernecks, but two of them broke free. It's a big defensive play for Western Illinois. They can ill afford to give the Bulldogs a score here and hope to come back.
Rochelle is 2 of 7 this half. He faces another big third down play. Nickel defense is on. Straight rush. The catch is made and dropped at the 32-yard line. Bart Leske, the intended.
Sims, number 20 on the backfield with a crushing block here on 86 coming in from the right side, which was Demetrius Davis. And Bart Leske just lost concentration thinking about the hit that was forthcoming. Didn't bring the ball all the way into his belt.
So fourth down, punting situation. Well, look at that. At the 8-yard line. Fresno State leading 17-7, 11:34 to play.
October to 26, KMPH.
Singer on first down goes to his running back. And Millsap gains very little, maybe nothing. Second down long.
It's in the point of the game where it's fun to play defense if you're Fresno State. You have the lead. You're overpowering the offensive front, and they're just going after everybody. Again, I think they either have to try, they don't believe they can get wide at Western Illinois. So, again, I think they have to go back to the pass game, but they have to roll the quarterback out of the cup, and they haven't done that. Look at this. This is a straight drop back.
Bragg is knocked down at the 20-yard line, but he has a first down, and how he held onto it, I don't know, because he was really busted. And Singer had to feel the pressure from Jethro Franklin as well from his right defensive end spot.
I think they have to get Singer out of the cut, but he stays in there and takes the hit, and a great catch downfield by Bragg. It was thrown behind him, but he was able to get it, and Rod Webster made the stop. That was great individual efforts, but again, Singer's team around him is getting dominated, and they're not going to be able to drive the length of the field unless they do something to give him some more time.
16 first downs for Western Illinois. 10 and a half to play. Singer to Bragg, first down, 35, 36 yard line.
There's a gifted athlete, this Tom Bragg.
They're just finding the seams in that zone. Bragg has three catches. You see the yardage.
I know Jeff Prentice is good, but it's hard to believe that Bragg isn't a starter. Bragg hurt his wrist in the spring, but he's a quality football player, and he'll get a lot of action this year at Western Illinois.
Blair Holloway will pick him up in the rover spot this time. Singer backs to throw. Bragg again there. He's open and has another first down. Inside the 45-yard line at the 42. Tony Harris making the touchdown saving tackle.
Paul Singer making a believer out of everybody at Bulldog Stadium. A little bit movement in that pocket. Better protection this time. And again, he looks for Bragg, his tight end, who beats double team coverage. Bragg is putting on a clinic for the tight end. He shows you can go over the middle and now go outside.
You let a team in a ball game long enough, they believe they can win. I think Western Illinois believes they can win this football game. 9 minutes, 53 seconds to play. Fresno State leading 17-7. Singer from the shotgun. On the delay. This is Grimshaw. Big game. He's to the 30. He's to the 20. Out of bounds.
Talk about the draws and the screens. This is the draw. Fresno State thinking pass. You go back to the draw. You try to cross them up. Grimshaw there breaks a tackle. And look at him toe dance the sideline. Is he in or out? Well, they say he was in, although it's very close, and that Webster's going to chuck him out of bounds. But right now, Western Illinois has got a second life. Fresno State had an opportunity to put him away and was unable to do it.
Well, where you saw that footstep out of bounds, that's where the referee caught it as well. So from the 31-yard line, it's a first down. Singer will throw. It is incomplete. 27-yard line. The coverage was there from James Rivera. A flag down at the 35.
Again, Singer stays in the pocket as you take a ground level view. Good throw, but Prentice couldn't quite climb the ladder here. And Rivera able to use the right hand to knock the ball away. You see those hankies on the field too. And that could spell trouble for the offense as they talk with Jethro Franklin. Ferguson rushing, and you see the hold there from behind. That's not a hold, that's an out and out grab. And for the Leathernecks, well, maybe an embrace would be a better way, as Scott Lewis really was mugging Dave Ferguson.
I've seen Roddy Piper.
You know, your
looks right. Like that. Singer looping it downfield. He has a man open, and it's a touchdown for Grimshaw. Grimshaw wide open at the 15-yard line, and the fans from Western Illinois, who have been able to squeeze their way into a jam-packed Bulldog Stadium, cheering on their sideline. It is 17-13.
Grimshaw came out of the backfield. Nobody picked him up, and he is wide open. Now, this is a linebacker assignment, but there's not a linebacker in the area, and Grimshaw is gone. Third time this year that Fresno State has been beaten with linebackers coming and the backs getting free.
And Bennett makes it 17-14.
That was an impressive drive.
24 seconds remaining in this football game. And Fresno State's lead is but three.
To celebrate Pepsi's victory over Coke Classic, we're holding
the ultimate choice sweepstakes. What does it mean?
It means we'll whisk you away on a private jet for 10 days of frolic and fantasy. It means you can win a great 10-day trip.
Visit a trio of playgrounds preferred by the posh and pampered.
You can visit three American cities.
Share your good fortune with five grateful companions.
It means you can bring five friends.
So shampoo.
It means good luck.
Shampoo.
These days, an O'Neill sprinkler system isn't a luxury, it's a necessity. All you need is a short weekend to install a Buckner pop-up and shrub spray system. O'Neill Irrigation will also design your system using the newest Buckner automatic controllers. Just bring in your yard measurements to our experts and we'll provide, with your purchase, all the parts, blueprints, and instructions to do it right. O'Neill Irrigation and Buckner Sprinklers. Free design and delivery and number one for low prices. O'Neill Irrigation on Sierra, just east of Blackstone.
10 plays, 92 yards. Paul Singer is back at it. The final 41 to his running back Grimshaw. We have ourselves a game again.
Amazing. amazing drive because his offense was able to rally around itself and pick up its pass blocking protection, and they got a little creative offensively as well.
On the return, Anthony Williams can't find an opening, and he's down at the 22-yard line.
See, this is like watching a Rocky movie. Here's Fresno State just pounding on Western Illinois the last couple quarters, knocking them down, and Western Illinois, being the Rocky, keeps getting back up, and they're just not quitting. Like Rocky, they will not quit. Little fumble-itis on the specialty team here, and sometimes that's a problem for the
face mask on the defense. First down.
As a penalty is on the defenders coming down as they took Williams down by the face guard. But sometimes when you drop the ball, that'll freeze the defense enough for the on-rushing people where you can find a crease. It didn't occur there, though.
27-yard line. Dean Collins with a big hole and up near a first down. I believe he has it. He needed to get to the 38-yard line. And they'll mark it at the 39. No, yes, it is a first down. And, you know, now is a time where this young man, number 12, Eric Bruchel, must step up and grab the bull by the horns and lead this football team, because they must get the momentum back for victory number one in 1987.
I like it.
Bruchel on the keeper is out of bounds at the 50-yard line.
I like it. A different look. Great fake to Courtney Griffin. Watch 38 go back. He fakes everybody out, but it's Bruchel that has the ball. The flow is to the right, and there's Bruchel on a naked quarterback keep, and he takes what the defense gives him. He's not going to take the hit from the secondary. That's pretty football.
Second down, Bulldogs need two. Fresno State just leading by three with 8 minutes, 53 seconds to play in this ball game. Nothing there for Dean Collins. He will lose a yard, and it will be third down and three, maybe even four.
Been rough treading in the middle all night for the Bulldogs. Leathernecks have been able to jam that up.
Demetrius Davis and Rick Renner, their only returning starter on defense, were able to wrap up Dean Collins that play. And Fresno State is struggling 4 of 13 in third down conversions. And the biggest one of the game for Eric Bruchel right here. Dropped the football at the 47-yard line. Excellent coverage coming from Kelly Duncan.
Bruchel looking for Brock Smith, who's been open most of the night, but this time number 6 Wilcox timed it perfectly and was able to knock it away from Brock. And the momentum has certainly swung in favor of Western Illinois here.
Well, they took it 92 yards in 10 plays minutes earlier. They will get it again. Fair catch, 15-yard line. Reese Smith, and a flag goes down. With 7 minutes and 58 seconds.
One rocking evening at the Silver Bullet.
This band sure is loud.
Oh, thanks. I just bought it.
Want to dance?
No, they got Coors Light.
You can't hear me, can you? I think you're beautiful. In fact, I think you look so hot in here, isn't it? Of course, it's not so much the heat as it is the humidity.
There's no slowing down with Silver Bullet tonight.
17-14. There's a penalty flag on the field on the punt, and it is against Fresno State.
Interference. They did not give the return man. It's a 5-yard penalty. It's not contact. See, 42 there, face guard.
First down.
It's like a pass. You have to give him room to receive the ball. Maurice Smith there, 42 for the Bulldogs. Robert Noble, reserve linebacker. You have to give the man an opportunity to catch the ball, and he didn't, although it was fielded by Smith.
Another good game for Grimshaw. Wilburn having to run him out of bounds. Gain of 5, maybe 6 yards.
You have to lock up when you're a tackler. 91 Ferguson did not lock him up. arm tackling, you got to get lower. He didn't get that body into him. He tried to wrap him up with the arms, and it didn't work. Wilburn, as you said, did run him out. But Grimshaw turned a potential loss into a six-yard gain.
He's having another fine night. He had 95 yards last week. Last week, he averaged 10.5 per carry. Leathernecks need four. Singer wants to throw. Has a man open. The catch is made, and Bragg again. And it's a first down.
Singer is really showing his merit here. He takes a terrific hit on this play from Jethro Franklin, coming from his right on the delivery sack, but he still was able to get a nice aerial off and find Bragg, who's become his favorite target.
Bragg has four of his five catches in the game, and this is a very important second half for Western Illinois. With 7.5 minutes remaining, Bulldogs clinging to a three-point lead. Singer drops back in the shotgun. Here's the inside reverse to Michael Cox, to the 40, to the 41. That's all. Bulldog defense that looks so impressive to start the second half is all of a sudden struggling.
Well, remember, they've been on the field a long time. Little delay there, counterplay, again to try to cross up the defense. And you can look for Singer on second and six to go back to his tight end, because Bragg's been open in the entire second half. Those are terrific numbers.
He had three touchdown passes last week, four now for the year. Is made at the 32-yard line. Jethro Franklin and Nick Ruggieroli.
67 was not to be denied. Singer in the shotgun is going to try to wiggle free, but there he is. Watch how strong he is here. I'll take you down with one arm. And the left arm drags him down by that shirt. And Ruggieroli says, hey, this is a good way for me to get in the assist column.
Vic Jacobs is out on the sideline. Vic, what's happening?
He's talking with Brian Rabach, number 77 of Western Illinois. The offensive line is very confident of pushing out the Bulldogs for a scoring drive. Let's see what happens down in the fourth quarter. Back to you guys in the booth.
Flag is down. Singer on third and 15. It is broken up, almost intercepted by Rod Webster. He had it in his hands, and he also perhaps could have had the right sideline.
Now there's a flag down. You want to move Singer, but you don't want him to completely roll out. And this play's out of control, and he's just trying to run for his life. He wanted Prentice, the tight end, and Webster really should have intercepted the ball. That's why they have the tip drill. Unfortunately for Rod and the crew, there was no Bulldog in the area.
Illegal procedure to call.
On the offense, refuse, fourth down.
Mike Krause. Alexander back at his 30. Krause has averaged just under 40 yards per kick tonight. They're setting the return to the right side. Alexander fumbles the football. It's out of bounds at the 18-yard line. And we will pause with 5:54 to play. Fresno State 17, Western Illinois 14. Tackle once again. Clock winding down at 5:40.
Great punt by Krause. Forced Alexander back, and now the Bulldogs don't have field position. They have to root out a couple first downs here. This is a very confident Leatherneck team that mentally was out of the game in the third quarter and has been able to rally here in the fourth.
Skipper to the 20. That's all. To the 22-yard line.
Great reaction, because that's a good call to isolate Skipper and give him some room out on the flat. And Wade, that nickelback, who's really a linebacker, snuffed it out.
Gain of two, it'll be third down and five.
If you have a bread and butter play, this is where you want to come to it.
Bouchel is sacked. Inside the 15-yard line. A big play. It's fourth down, and Western Illinois will get the football back in great field position.
Romolino, the linebacker, was coming, but Bouchel makes the smart play here. He's got a three-point lead. Take the loss, take the sack, and hope the defense can hold on.
I'll tell you, number 44 has been everywhere. Marty Romolino. He's only 6 feet tall, 220 pounds, but he is in double figures in tackles. He had 20 last week in a victory over Arkansas Tech, and he's been all over the place tonight.
We just saw Krause hit a terrific punt for Western Illinois. Now Bella has to do it for Fresno.
We have 4.5 minutes left in this ball game. Fresno State by three. We'll pause for this timeout.
Even though you faithfully pay your premiums, why do some insurance companies make you feel so guilty?
I had an accident.
Do you have an estimate? 2 estimates, 3 estimates.
And a note from your mother.
My mother?
Leave it to the good hands, people.
In most cases, Allstate will give you a settlement on the spot without 3 estimates or a note from your mother.
How do we know it's her writing?
You're in good hands with Allstate.
A member of the Sears Financial Network.
17-14. Fresno State with a three-point lead, but Western Illinois will get the football back. Barry Belli is standing at his goal line, and he will punt that ball to Maurice Smith and Emmerich Wilcox. Both very fine return artists, and both standing right at the 40-yard line in their own territory. Smith at the 45. To the 50, that's all.
But still in all, very good field possession for the Leathernecks. They have plenty of time, 4:20. They have all their timeouts, and they're confident. They just want 92 yards for a touchdown.
They have 50 yards to go now to take the lead, and there's just 4 minutes and 20 seconds to work with. This may be, this is the biggest game of the year for Western Illinois. Their season can be absolutely sensational if they're able to upset Fresno State. Right now, the Bulldogs hoping that will not be the case. Singer back to throw. Completes the pass to Bragg. 43-yard line. He has caught 5 passes this half, 6 for the game.
At Western Illinois can afford to be patient. They have time. They have field position, and they're only down by 3. So they don't have to try to do anything too dramatic. They're going to take 5- and 6-yard patterns if they're given to them.
He has been a force here in the second half.
Size and speed for Bragg.
Again, Singer with plenty of time. The pass is caught by Bragg, and he is hit knocked down at the 28-yard line.
And hands, too. What a player. You talk about taking the hit, the willingness to play the game. Singer with a great throw, and watch this pop from Webster, and Bragg's going to get up and say, hey, I came to play tonight.
And Singer is sensational. He's a machine, a sewing machine. Singer is working for perfection.
We're
going
to put you at a nightclub. I like that. That's a good act you got, Steve.
Cox to the right, the 20. He's to the 17-yard line. Within Lane Bennett territory now.
The offense on all cylinders. They got the air game. They're blocking up front. It's an emotional game, and they feel they can block Fresno State. The Dogs had them, let them off the hook, and now that ebb and flow, that emotional flow, is all with the Leathernecks.
295 yards passing by Singer. And you know, this guy hasn't made a mistake. No interceptions, no fumbles. Down by 3. 57 to work with. Michael Cox again. Cuts inside to the 12-yard line.
You talk about being a winner. Paul Singer believes he can win. His team was a winning football squad with Singer called the singles last year. They won big over an outman Arkansas Tech football team last week. He just believes he's going to win the football game. And that's wonderful to have if you got that at the quarterback spot. Singer gives you that extra dimension. He believes he's going to win the game.
He has the time. It's incomplete at the 5-yard line. Forrest with the dive. Wilburn with the great coverage, though.
Well, the screws are tightened a little bit by the Fresno State defense. Attained with some pressure, but Singer had some time at the end as he moved to his left. And the adrenaline flow, and he threw it a little bit too strong. This is a huge third down play.
They need 6 yards. They look in the corner of the end zone. It's incomplete, and it's fourth down. And Western Illinois, with 2 minutes and 5 seconds to work with, will try and tie this game.
Fred Wilburn with great coverage in the secondary, and Steve Williams never really had a chance for Western Illinois. And Singer made the right play, he threw it away, and said, "Hey, let's go for the three rather than risk an interception."
He will come from 31 yards out. He missed one earlier from this distance, from the left hash mark. It is good, and we are tied at 17 with 2 minutes and 1 second to play in this ball game. Fresno State 17 and Western Illinois 17.
True Value Hardware Stores present a sneak preview of great values in the Fall Preview Circular. Choose the Master Mechanic single bit axe, maul, or sledgehammer, just $9.99 each. This Contico round trash can with sturdy lid is just $8.99. Get the Dorset 2 entry lock and deadlock by Quickset for only $17.88. And True Value Alkaline batteries in assorted sizes and packs are just $1.39. Now showing at participating True Value hardware stores and home centers.
Introducing the Bagel Breakfast Sandwich.
Come on over, baby. Won't be here for long.
Only at Burger King.
We ain't bacon. Whole lot of breakfast going on.
Fast, tasty breakfast.
Fresh eggs.
Bacon, ham, or sausage with melted cheese on a hot, soft bagel.
Come on over, baby. Whole lot of breakfast going on.
Burger King, the best food for fast times.
Game on KMPH tonight, the home opener for Fresno State. They have won 11 of their last 12 home openers. And the man who just provided the tying points, Lane Bennett, will kick off. Brock Smith. Hauled down at the 27-28-yard line. 55 to work with.
It'll be gut check time now for Eric Bouchel. He needs to move the team about 45 or 50 yards to try to get into Barry Belli field goal range. He has his full complement of timeouts. He can still afford to be patient as you see a fired up sideline for Western Illinois at 1:55 for Bouchel. So he has all the cards to play with. Let's see if he can do it.
He has an opening. No gain. Second down, 10, maybe 11 yards to go. But really, no receiver was open.
And tremendous pressure from the front wall of Western Illinois. Jim Sweeney, I guess, is very disappointed.
Bouchel going deep. It is incomplete. And it is third down and 10. And 1:28 remains. It's an old bulldog. The 13 colonies once said, these are the times that try men's souls. 4 of 14 in third down conversions tonight for Fresno State.
It's amazing how a game can turn around. The Bulldogs had all the momentum in the third quarter, but could not put the Leathernecks away. And suddenly, as you see that conversion ratio, the Leathernecks have taken control of the line of scrimmage.
going deep again. It's incomplete. Oh, my. And the crowd will move.
Well, there's still plenty of time now for Western Illinois to get into field goal range with their placement specialist, Lane Bennett. They have two timeouts, and a minute 22 remains in the game.
Fresno State still has not had a man this year. Dave Telford or Eric Bushell step forward and say, I will be Kevin Sweeney's replacement. And it has cost them thus far tonight through 59 minutes of college football. Maurice Smith with a fair catch at the 24-yard line. What was he doing?
Well, what he was doing was signaling late for the fair catch. And the crowd thought, hey, wait a minute, it should be called off. But he has the right to call for that fair catch. And you can see that he's applauding his teammates. Maurice Smith makes the catch, now waves. But he had given an indication earlier than that.
That makes no sense at all. You got a chance to fall forward, fall forward. They've got 75 yards to go, a minute 11 to work with. Fresno State needs a big defensive play. Let's see if they can get it from Singer right here. He has not made many mistakes tonight.
Haven't made any really mistakes. He hasn't turned the ball over at all.
The pass is caught at the 33-yard line. First down, Don Beebe. And the timeout is called with 1:03 to play.
I don't think they called the timeout. What they did was just move the sticks.
Yes.
I don't believe they did call the timeout.
No. They're keeping it right here. They're keeping it.
I'm working on my own now, and it's great.
But I'm not covered by a group health plan anymore. And with hospital costs at $700 a day, well, I still need the coverage more now than ever. I called Blue Cross of California. Now, they have a plan called the Personal Prudent Buyer. It's every bit as good as any group health plan. It's nice to know that somebody still thinks about us individuals.
Call your agent or Blue Cross at 772-3200.
57 seconds remaining in this football game. Second down and 10. You see the score. 37-yard line.
Have to put some pressure on Singer.
The pass is dropped. Grimshaw, the man who caught the touchdown pass of 41 yards that pulled Western Illinois to within three, drops this one, and it was near a position where he could have gotten the first down. It'll be third down and 10. And James Rivera, two times in a row now, has broken up a reception.
Well, this is the third down that Western Illinois has to have, or Fresno State may actually have another opportunity. Look for him to go back to his tight end, Bragg, who's been so successful over the middle.
How about Rod Webster right now? 52 seconds. They need 10. The pass is caught. Not a first down. It's fourth down. 46 seconds to go in decision time for Western Illinois. I believe they've got to punt the football, and they will.
He really wanted Bragg over the middle, but Bragg was well covered for that time, and so he had to go to a secondary target. Good defense by the Bulldogs.
Good decision by Singer. You just can feel the big play people like Rod Webster stepping up and making something happen. He just had the big tight end covered that time.
You don't want to force anything at this point. They have a tie, which is like a win for them.
Alexander will let it go out of bounds. Bad punt by Mike Krause.
That one really hurts. After having such a beautiful punt earlier in the quarter, Bulldogs are going to be stationed right at their 30-yard line. They have 40 seconds, and they have all three timeouts. That was a great defensive stand by the Fresno State defense. They're able to get three plays and a punt and really give their team two opportunities in 2 minutes. Give the offensive team two opportunities to get Belli set up.
And you just need to get past midfield to have that chore done. The catch is made. Out of bounds. Near the first down. They will mark him out at the 39-yard line. So Fresno State will need 2 yards for the first down, and they have 33 seconds to work with. And that man very concerned right now. He's been with Fresno State for 10 years.
Might be a tendency to go for a deep play here and pick up a large chunk, feeling that you can get your first down on third down. Also, you have to be cognizant of the clock with 33 seconds left.
Timeout here, and we will keep it here with 33 seconds. Our score is tied at 17. Timeout situation. Western Illinois with one left. Fresno State has three, and it is second down and two.
Makeable field goal for Barry Belon is 55 yards and in. We saw him try one just last week. As you see, the brain trust of the Bulldogs around quarterback Eric Bushell. We saw Belli try one from 62 and nearly make it. Again, no wind here, so the conditions are almost ideal. He feels he can hit from 55, but you really don't want to put him in that kind of situation. You'd like to get him a 40 or a 45-yard attempt, which is a legitimate, makeable field goal. With that in mind, the Bulldogs need 30 yards.
Well, Rich Olson, given the instructions to Eric Bushell, knows are his numbers. The one touchdown pass came in the first half to Kelly Skipper. It was 14-7 at halftime. And Fresno State has scored with 3 points in the second 30 minutes. Second and two.
Stop with the chains being moved, and they also have the opportunity to stop it with two timeouts.
From the I formation, the give, the run by Kelly Skipper. He's to the 50-yard line, and he is down at the 46. Great block by Brian Fallon, the center.
Very predictable call, though, on third and two. First priority is to pick up the first down. He had to get to the 41, but there's a lot more there. And then when it broke open, Skipper gets into Leatherneck territory. And now the Bulldogs will use that timeout. They still have one more. But they had to get the 2 yards before you can think about winning the game.
Yes, indeed. Well, we were in this position just a yard further when Belli tried that 62-yard field goal and barely missed it last week. You know Jim Sweeney wants more. Vic Jacobs is down on the sideline. I'm sure, Vic, the tension is terrific.
It's a virtual tempest of emotion down here. Fresno State can win the game with a field goal, but I remember, Randy, you were saying that you don't think there's much wind. Well, there's a bit of a crosswind down here. Watch. I'm going to throw the grass up and watch. You can see the wind actually moved left to right. There is a wind. I think that's going to affect the field goal attempt. Back to you guys in the booth.
But there is not enough wind to bend Vic Jacobs' hair. It continues to stand straight up.
You know, that's ironic because Vic's down on the field. We're up above. If we look at the flagpole, it's totally limp, not even a zephyr of a breeze. But down on the field, that's a good report from Vic Jacobs. He gives us another angle, another dimension. Unfortunately for Barry Belli, he has to kick it from down there, not up here where there's no wind.
So from the 46-yard line and 23 seconds left, 17-17 our score. Bushell has time. Completes the pass to Ron Jenkins at the 25-yard line.
Patience by Eric Bushell. He'll be able to find his target. Great blocking from the offensive line. And Bushell, watch him. Patience. Wait. Now the break and the throw to Jenkins. 22 yards before Wilcox can get him.
He stepped up in the pocket, Randy, and that meant the big difference.
And he got a great performance from that front wall. And Jenkins with a crossing pattern. And now they're in definite field goal range, and I don't think they're going to wait. 16 seconds left. There is a tendency to bring Barry Belli on right now, although there's still plenty of time. They do have the option here to try to pass again or run it up to the middle of the field and use the final timeout.
Well, I think there's plenty of time for at least two plays, and it still would be a long field goal from here, at least 42 yards out. They may want to bring it back to the middle of the field. They're working from the right hash mark. The ball right now resting at the 24-yard line. And if they kick the field goal here, it would be from the seconds left.
I think you're correct in your assumption. Run it back to the middle of the field, use your final timeout, and then bring Bell IR.
Double tight end. Skipper gets one, maybe two.
But he did his job. He got the ball, wiggled up a couple yards closer to the goalpost. And a direct line for Barry Billy. Now look for the Leathernecks to use a timeout and try to freeze Barry Billy, much like a free throw shooter in basketball. You want him to think about the kick. So I wouldn't be surprised if they're just about ready to line up. You see the Leathernecks call a timeout.
Barry Billy has been sensational inside the 40 in his career. 37 of 40 inside the 40-yard line. This will come from about 39 yards out and straight away. He is a young man that has won so many games in his fabulous career. A three-year starter. He has one field goal tonight, 4 out of 5 for the season. This always takes me back to that situation at Ohio State several years ago when Oklahoma was visiting and Uwe von Schaman, in front of 100,000 fans that were yelling, block that kick, and Uwe von Schaman was yelling it as well, and he was the kicker, and he drilled it through from 45 yards out.
There's the timeout by the Leathernecks now. Make Barry Billy think about it. That's what they're trying to do here. You think it's easy to be a place kicker?
Vic Jacobs is down on the sideline. He's seen this situation many times in the past.
Well, Steve and Randy, I just want to say that, remember before the season, the three of us were down at the Bulldog practice field, and we all talked to Barry Billy about such a situation. And Steve, you said to him, do you like these situations? And Barry says, I love them. That's why I play football. So this is what he thrives on, as the three of us discovered in that Bulldog practice that day. Right or wrong?
And he said it with such conviction at that time that you believed it right along with him, not like any young man who would just say it simply to make you believe it. He felt it in his heart as well. You can go back to 1985 when he was able to hit a crucial 41-yarder that gave Fresno State a late 8-point lead and a winning margin in a 33-31 win over Long Beach State. Well, he has touched on many more in his great career. And I think those totals tell it all.
You know, he's going to want this one even more, though, Steve. He's a senior. This is his spotlight year. He's in front of the home fans and a home opener. This is a kick he really wants to put through.
11 seconds left. Out Jenkins to hold. He's unbelievable. It's 20-17, and Barry Billy, with 7 seconds remaining, has given Fresno State the edge.
Magic Johnson calls it winning time. It's Barry Billy time. This is right down Main Street. No question about it. Forget the freeze job. Barry Billy split it right down the middle. He could have shortened up the uprights. He still would have had it good.
Tied for 12th on the NCAA list for field goals. And Vic Jacobs, if you can get Barry Billy after this football game, see if you can, because he has been a magic man. How many times has he been in that situation in the past, and how many times has he answered that question? Will he kick it home? And he did it again.
A weapon. He's certainly worth somebody's draft choice in next year's NFL draft. He is unconscious.
After that one, I'd take him in the first round.
And he made it look easy.
Western Illinois has a hold. But the game is over. And Barry Billy, the champion again. with a 39-yard field goal with just 7 seconds left in this football game to give Fresno State a 20-17 victory, their first of 1987, and just a dramatic win here at Bulldog Stadium.